Okie dokie. Hey there guys, I'm Monocle. Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Now, we are at the Firelink Shrine because I have another ash, the Easterner's ash.
Gracious.
Let's see what we unlocked with that, shall we? Nothing here, I think. Large Titanite Chest. Okay, we did get large Titanite Chest now. Nothing new here. Scimitar, washing pole. Okay, washing pole. Twenty durability only. 20 dexterity requirement. Not that bad. Eastern iron shield. Yeah, I was kind of thinking about this one. Able to deflect attacks with ease, but it doesn't even have 100 physical protection, so... yeah. The Eastern set. I do like the Eastern set. It's quite nice if you want to do a... Oni Slayer's Great Arrow. Interesting. Okay.
Ashen.
Okay, can I upgrade anything more? No.
Well, very well, then.
Okay, that's 37. Only 37 now?
Farewell,
you know what, if we can, maybe I'll buy some embers if I can. Can I? You don't have any more embers, huh? Well, in that case... Okay. And we can go back where we were. So, we can go into Irithyll Dungeon or back to here. Pontiff. Let's go to Pontiff, whatever that is, and let's continue to this area. I did open up a small shortcut here. So we're gonna use that. This here. It's not really that big of a shortcut. To be completely honest, it's not that big of a shortcut, but it's better than other ones, I guess. Fuck you, fire motherfuckers. Okay, now, I did find a secret here. Two things first. Let's go up, let's see where... Oh, this leads me back here, right? To the, yeah. This leads me back here, and I can go up and fight those giant archers. But before we do that, in that case, let's go down. And let's see what we can do with this. Because this is not a fun area. I already see this is not a fun area. I did unlock this yesterday. And you can see that enemy there. That's not a fun enemy. That is not a fun enemy. No. No, he is not. That's the dude that one-shotted me last time. Time for range battle. Yeah. Looks like that. What? This is not in range? Really? Oh, there's more than one. Great. What? How are you supposed to fight this thing? I don't understand how are you supposed to fight this thing, really. And there are two of them there. Just make it even nicer. He's not giving up, by the way. He's not giving up, as you can see. Yep. Yep. He attacks faster than I can chaga Estus after getting hit once. That's the enemy design that they made here. That's the enemy that they designed here. You saw that he hit me once? I tried to use a Estus and my character died before I could even take out the Estus and drink it. That's what they designed here. Nice game. Nice. Good on you. Good for you. You fucking piece of shit. Wow. I don't know how I'm gonna kill those two. There are two of them there. Like, one was a fucking huge problem, and there's two of them. Even a drop-down attack on him did not help me. It took more of my HP away than his. Really? Two of them at once? Fuck you! Two of them at... What are you supposed to do here? Game! Go yourself. Two of them aggro at once. You know what? Go fuck yourself. That's what I'm gonna tell you. Go suck a big fat dick and go fuck yourself. Like, come on! One of them kill, two shots me and they aggro two of them at once in an area like that. That is just being a dick. There's no other explanation, right? Wow! It hit me in the other direction. It actually hit me in the other... physics. Naughty. Now they think that they know, I guess. Physics is not their strong suit, I guess. Okay, let's see where this leads first. Was I here already? I guess I was here already. Maybe, yeah, I think I dropped down something here earlier. Or something. Okay. I went here already. Just me, or is he attacking very fast with those? He almost hit me there, by the way. He basically almost two-shotted me there. Great game. Great. Sadness. Nothing here. Really? So why was this guy here? Ugh. My hand is sweaty. Hey, dude. Hey. Hey, you. I want you to come after me. Please. Yeah, come here. Yep. Yeah. leader of Dawn but didn't kill himself. Interesting. Wow. Wow, game. That's a new low from you. He did not even connect to me, yet according to the game, he hit me dead. And my character fell down. Like, that was not even close, and that was not the right angle. It's like they made the arrows always throw you down, no matter at what angle they hit you at. Like earlier, when I got hit in my back and I fell on my back, like, what? What is that? Where do you take physics like that? Like, I understand what you are doing. You're trying to make the archers intimidating that they can throw you off a cliff and shit, but if I get hit in my back, I don't fucking fall on my back. I fall forward on my face. Like, that's how physics work, you know? Illusionary wall. Yeah, it does seem like it. Gwendolyn. Gwendolyn? Yeah, Gwendolyn. Gwendolyn's room. Interesting. Ember. Vision of bonfire. Yeah, but I don't see a bonfire. Can I? Oh, I can. Okay. Well, if this is how it should be, then there should be a bonfire somewhere there. Shouldn't there? I will backtrack, by the way, but first I want to find a bonfire or something, so I will have some progression done. Those are the double stairs of Anno Londo. Oh, and there is a bonfire. Great, okay. Anno Londo. Well, we were technically in Anno Londo earlier already, but... But I get what you're telling me, game. From the other side then. By the way, all enemies have so much damage on them, it really is a bit ridiculous. I didn't find an enemy yet that didn't one-shot me. I didn't find an enemy that didn't one-shot me, or two-shot me at max. Like, I understand what they are trying to do. They are making you feel like, you know, it's extremely difficult to progress and stuff like that, but like, if every enemy has multiple hit combos and they kill me with one hit, just, you know, think about that for a moment. Is that really difficult, or is that just lazy? Gonna be a shortcut, I think. Yeah, this is gonna be a shortcut. That's that door that I saw earlier. Right? Yep. This is the door that I saw earlier. One thing that I don't like is the amount of damage that enemies have, and that's from the start of Dark Souls 3. Enemies just have so much damage, like I don't understand. How am I supposed to fight them if they deal so much damage? Wow, that's so much damage for me. And the lock-on is so good. Dragon Slayer Great Bow, okay. Was worth getting this item. Definitely. I still don't understand how am I supposed to fight those fucking dogs down there. Two of them at once. But whatever, I guess. Okay, let's see where the Guinevere door leads. Or Gwyndolin. I never remember which one is which. Gwyndolin is the big booby, right? And Guinevere is the sun that looks like a chick, right? I think. Or the other way around. Never remember. Brass armor. Oh, cool. I did like the brass armor. The helm looked nice. We'll see in a moment how it looks here. They even left the flowers here. Reversal ring, okay, cool. See, we got some. We got some items here. I like the fact that they made the torch work the same way as in Bloodborne, where you just have it equipped and you change to it instantly and it doesn't have a timer on it or anything like that. Okay, let's see the brass set. First of all, it doesn't weigh that much. Let's see. Armor of a knight once known as the Dark Moon. It is said that this brass armor hides something hideous within. Something about this silhouette suggests femininity. Femininity. Yeah, she was a female. I like that they are playing with the idea that after such a long time, you cannot know who was who, right? Like, the fact that the iron set, the Iron Tarkus set is used by someone else, and people don't remember that Iron Tarkus was the guy using it before. And stuff like that. I do like that. Okay, it doesn't look bad, but it doesn't work with my look. I like that. I like the fact that they are playing with that idea that people just after, you know, millennia or whatever, people don't know who originally wore that item or that, you know, that gear. So they just talk about guys that at the present time or in the not so long past were known for using a certain item, certain weapon, stuff like that. And that's how we learn. And that's how people perceive those items, right? Oh, used by this guy, because I never heard about that guy that you're talking about. And I do like that. It's fun. Because, like, that's how history really works, right? Like, you don't remember, and like, people don't know that well ancient history. Like, we have only scraps of information. Like, I'm not talking, like, history like Roman history. Like, I'm not talking 1,000 years ago or 2,000 years ago. I'm talking about like 10,000 years ago. Like, how much do we actually know about our own history, the world's history, from 10 or 15,000 years ago, right? Not that much. The thing is, people were not too people were not sophisticated back then and were not, you know, that advanced. Don't know if writing was even if people knew how to write even at those times, but just the whole fact that we don't know what was happening in the world 10,000 years ago. People were definitely, humans are older than 10,000 years, so. Really? That's gonna be your fucking attack, you asswipe. And as you can see, enemies do give a lot of epic materials. Every basic enemy that I killed so far has had a high chance of giving me, like, at least regular Titanite shots. Locked by some contraption. Yeah, I even know what contraption. Wonder if we will find a giant blacksmith. That would be cool. Probably not, but that would be cool. Although, being a bit honest, I like the fact that they are giving us the ability to go back to Anno Londo, but, like, being completely honest, this is a bit lazy in terms of design. Like, they are basically reusing the same fucking stuff, right? Oh, he's dead. Oh, giant skull. Oh, poor giant, you died. That's sad. You are such a good giant friend. You friend, me work, me not talk, you talk, me happy. Like, he had dialogues like that, I remember. Oh. Poor giant. Okay, they changed something with the interior. Yeah, they changed a lot with the interior. This is not how it looked. Wow, you barely see me and you already are casting spells. Open this up, please. Oh, come on. Aldrich Ruby, huh? Okay. Well, I did open up this area. Let's first go here. Why do you have red eyes? Wow, that damage though. I guess red eye dudes have more damage on them. I'm guessing. Vision of Joy. Well, I don't see anything. Maybe from the other side there's a secret here or something, but not from here. This was not a door in Dark Souls 1 also, by the way. By the way, I hope that is an enemy that doesn't respawn, that the one that I killed, because if it's a respawning enemy... Every enemy that takes more than 4 or 5 hits to kill... is a huge problem. Especially with a big-ass fucking weapon like I'm using, right? Really? Yeah. WoW game. I actually cannot move close to them. Wow. That was fun. Huh? Fun. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Why do they insist on doing stuff like this? Really? How about that? I'm gonna headshot you, little fucker. Such a good feeling. That's why you always should have a bow with you. The only problem is the composite bow that I'm using has short range, right? But this is the only bow that I can use without spending any points into dexterity. You? See? Slow progress. Sometimes the best way. Slow, careful progress, I should say. Like Wrath of the Gods, wasn't it? How am I not hitting you? Really? Deep gem, huh? Okay. Are you kidding me that this is a grab ahead, or could this be a prince? Are you really kidding me that this is a boss fight now, after so many enemies in this area? Like, granted, they are not tough enemies or anything, but, like, come on. A bazillion snipers at once and then a boss? Oh, I will not like this, will I? I don't see anything more here. Don't see any other items. Okay, let's try the boss, and if I'm gonna fail, which I will probably, I will just quit out from the game. And home at bone and try to do the boss again. So let's use an ember. Why not? I have two Estus left. I have a shield up. I can always very fast quit out. Aldrich, the power of gods. Okay. I already know that I have to quit out from this guy, because I need more magic resistance.
Then touch the darkness.
Touch the darkness inside me.
Well, very well then. Farewell, Abby.
Now, can I have my bow equipped or not? Let's see. Only gives you like 20%. It's not like Dark Souls 1 where it gave you 50%. Kinda sucks. Okay, I found a new ember, so let's give it to Andre. Give coal. I'm sorry, coal, not ember.
Peaceable giant. Seems like ages passed. I imagine his passing was long ago. I miss the old bugger, I do. My thanks. I'll be sure this coal is put to good use. I'll be smithing weapons never afore seen by the likes of ye. It's but a small service to pay my humble respects.
Still don't have another Titanite chunk. That sucks, really. I don't have any more of these. So now what I can do with weapons? Let me see. Heavy, sharp, refined, raw, crystal, simple, fire, chaos, lightning, blessed, deep, poison. Yeah, 20 dexterity also required.
Oh, by the way, if you find any Estus shard, they can be used without... Pretty like that.
Okay. Is my friend back? No, he's not. I wonder where he is. He got kinda lost after I sent him on the last,
Speak honorable. Ah, greetings, our lord and liege. Good tidings. My spouse is ready.
My spouse?
The time is ripe to greet her. The girl awaits thee in the hidden dark moon chamber of Anor Londo. So thou mayst a true monarch become. Ah, good.
Hidden chamber in Anor Londo. That sounds interesting. A little rendezvous. Interesting. So let's just spend all of the souls, because I definitely will die, so might as well buy all the resins that I can. Great magic shield would be nice right now. Great magic barrier, I'm sorry. Would be nice right now, to be honest. Really nice to have it. I hope that monster here is not... Fuck. This boss. Hey, Dernay. Going well, man. Just trying to kill another boss and having a problem with it, as always. But besides that, I'm good. Do I know any Russians being Polish? No. And now she's got a fire buff on her, interesting. Wow! Wow! Oh, come on! That didn't hit me. Wow! Really? Like, come on! Hey there, Dominic. Such a fine day to get annoyed by a weird boss. Wow, really? Fuck you, bitch. This is probably one of the most annoying bosses that I fought in a very long time. I don't understand what's her deal. Like, every boss has a mechanic, right? Bosses have mechanics. You are supposed to learn the mechanics and know how to fight her. She has mechanics that I do not understand. She has homing range attacks, attack that goes through walls, which is the Crystal Soul Spear, melee attacks that deal a shit ton of damage, a teleport, and she's got an AoE attack that covers the whole map and lasts for like 5 to 10 seconds and chases you, which I mean the bow attack, where she gets a bow from somewhere and magic arrows start attacking the ground after you. Like, how do you avoid all of that? I don't understand this boss. Like, I really don't understand this boss. I don't see an opening ever, if you're alone especially. If she only targets you, I don't see where you get an opening to do anything against her.